We end tonight with a story of devotion, one couple's devotion to finding and protecting beauty once scattered by history and now gathered in a single collection, a cultural inheritance for African Americans.
If we start knowing about our people, we'll start changing about who we are.
The shared treasures of Bernard and Shirley Kinsey is on display at the Smithsonian's National Museum of American History.
An exhibit that celebrates the history and culture of African Americans.
The first private collection at the new African American Gallery.
We came here like the English came here in 1619, 1 year before the Mayflower. So you know what I say? We got this.
The shared treasures of Bernard and Shirley Kinsey now greets visitors to the busiest museum in all the world.
I love this brother. Rhodes Scholar in 1907. He gave black folks the permission to paint and to write. If anybody's got a dime in their pocket, there's a sister that did that. Where do you think the word cowboy came from? If they were white, they'd have been cowmen. You understand? Here's a brother writing a book in 1550 about black folks and black Africa. You never heard of it. So let me tell you what. We bring them out of the grave. We put them on the street. We give them names. We give them voices. We give them personalities. We tell you where they got their hair cut, where they got their clothes cleaned. Because you know a brother invented dry cleaning in 1820. You understand what I'm saying? Okay, let's go.
When Bernard and I began our journey through life together 45 years ago, we soon began to realize that we didn't know enough about our very own culture, and that's where we got started. We decided to collect what I call our collective ancestry, all the wonderful stories and contributions of our people.
Instead of embracing our history, many of us are ashamed of our history and ancestors, and because of this lack of knowledge, our children do not know who we are and where we came from. Shame on us. Now, you would say, well, why don't we know about this stuff? It's called the myth of absence. The myth of absence basically says that we're invisibly present. We're invisibly present. That means that we're there, but we're just not part of the picture. Not part of the dialogue that happens in this country.
Anytime you get the word slave, I want you to say enslaved. When you hear the word mercantilism, it means kidnapping. There are the stories that made America, and there are the stories that America made up. We want to motivate, educate, and inspire you to do more to tell our story and be proud of the African-American experience and being African-American. You come from a great place. And because you come from a great place, you don't have to walk into the doors backwards. You follow me? You got dibs here. Did I say it? Now, you hear me? All right, let's keep going.
Change gonna come.